Sniper Leader, Yorktown's lookouts have just sighted Jap scout planes. The Japs know where we are.
We'd better get moving then.
You know the drill. Get to work.
We're up and ready, Control.
Proceed to the designated coordinates. Reaper Leader, I don't need to remind you of the urgency here. You need to shut down the Jap carrier. They'll be scrambling their planes for a counterattack.
We'll get them, Control. The boys have a taste for sinking carriers since the Shoho went down.
I hope so. Just remember, the Shokaku and the Zuikaku are a much larger fleet carrier.
Roger that, Control. We're up to the task.
Good to hear. Give them hell.
Control.
What is it, Reaper Leader?
The Japs got mobile sooner than we expected. We've spotted their counterattack. It's on its way. There's dozens of them, mixed types. Permission to engage, Control.
Negative, Reaper Wing. Proceed with mission. Do not engage. I repeat, do not engage.
That's bull, Bobby. They're gonna cause some serious damage. We can take them.
You lock that down, Reaper One. Stay with me.
Our Corsairs are already in the air. They'll do more than you ever could to those dive bombers.
Well, I don't know about that.
Stick to the mission. It's critical that those carriers go down. All of the concerns are secondary.
Understood, Control. Control, enemy fleet is in visual range. Looks like there's a lone refueler ship ahead, separated from the group. The rest of the fleet is a few clicks beyond.
Sounds like a good opportunity to run through some dive bombing basics until those torpedo boys catch up. Now, steep and fast, the name of the game. You need to start your attack from altitude to get a nice steep angle and lots of speed. If you don't, your bombs won't penetrate the ship's armor properly. Practice on that lone ship. Let's see if you can send her to the bottom.
Dive bombing was the best part of training. This should be fun.
Just remember not to crash into the target, Reaper One. A lot of pilots seem to forget that part.
You got it, Control. Sink ship, don't crash. Refueler is sinking. She's gone. Control, objective is complete. Control, come in.
What the heck is going on, boss?
Damn it. It's gotta be the Jap counterattack. They're hitting our fleet.
We've gotta go back. They need our help.
No, Reaper One. We have to carry out the mission. Dealing with these carriers is the best way we can help. The torpedo bombers have caught up, so it's time to begin our runs. I want all the torpedo bombers to target the destroyers and the other anti-air escorts. Reaper Wing, you guys hit the Zuikaku. I'll hit the Shokaku, and the torpedoes can assist once the AA is down.
Roger that, boss.
aircraft destroyed. Fighters left. Carrier planes are clear. Reaper wing, break formation and proceed to your designated targets. Hit the bridge first. That should stop them maneuvering too much. There goes the bridge. What's the Sukaku status, Reaper One?
We're still working on it. Bridge is damaged, and the deck is taking damage too.
We're running out of time, boys. I'm gonna focus fire on the deck. We can at least shut down their operational capabilities. Hurting. Just need a few more hits. That's it. She won't be launching planes anytime soon. Reaper Wing, we've pushed our luck hanging around here this long, so let's get out of here.
Finally. I hope the guys are okay. At least shutting down the carrier should have helped them.
That was the plan, Reaper One. Now, let's haul ass.
Reaper Wing, come in.
Control, is that you?
Affirmative, Reaper Leader.
What the hell is going on? We lost comms with you. Assume the worst.
Well, we're alive. We've sustained heavy damage, but we're still floating. They knocked out our long-range comms. Our Corsairs have repelled most of the Jap planes, but took heavy damage. We could use your assistance cleaning up the last of these stragglers.
Roger, Control. We are inbound. Scratch that fighter. Target destroyed. He's going in.
Reaper Leader, we've got a strong radar signal to your south. I need you to check it out ASAP.
Got it, Control. Coming up on the location now.
Boss, what the hell is that?
It looks like a Jap sub.
That's too big to be a sub. Did you see that? It just launched a damn plane.
Control, we've got a Jap sub here, biggest we've ever seen. Looks like it's capable of launching damn planes.
A carrier submarine? The Japs are nuts.
What are our orders, Control?
What do you think? Take it out.
Affirmative, Control. Let's stop it from sending up any more fighters. Target the launching catapults.
Watch out for those escorts, Reaper Leader. Watch out for that sub's AA. Looks like there's a blind spot directly above it, so attack from above.
That's a hit. One more should do it.
Launching catapults are out. Nice work, boss.
Can't let that thing get away, Reaper Wing. You should be able to target the ballast tanks on the side. That will prevent her from diving and escaping.
Thank you. starboard tank is busted. Port tank is gone. She's not diving now, Control.
Good work. Now, send it to the bottom.
Good hits. She shouldn't take much more. Sub is going under, Control. Scope is clear.
Well done, Reaper Wing. We've dealt a good blow to the Japs today, but not without cause. Yorktown and Lexington are both badly damaged. We might not be able to take planes on for much longer, so get yourselves home as quickly as possible.
Roger that, Control. We're inbound.
Lexington is ready to take you aboard. yourself on deck.
We're down, Control.
Received, Reaper Leader. Well done. Once you've got that bird stowed, report for damage control duty.
The Battle of the Coral Sea proved the effectiveness of aircraft carriers. During the battle, the two fleets never even saw each other, just sent their planes at each other over the open ocean. On numbers, we lost that battle. We lost a destroyer and a carrier, the Lexington, and the Yorktown took a direct bomb hit that killed 63 sailors. Strategically, though, we actually won. The Japs had been rolling roughshod over us through the Pacific, and the Coral Sea was the first time we actually won a battle and stopped their advance. We also sunk one of their carriers, the Shoho, and severely damaged another, the Shikaku. Back home, things were getting moving. We tried for years to stay out of the war, but once we were in it, the entire might of the U.S. was focused on one thing, victory. Every able-bodied man and woman was mobilized to fight or work in this total war. The Axis forces posed a threat to our way of life. No effort was spared. While we were off fighting, the people back home were doing their bit too. A rationing system was introduced, price controls were imposed, and taxes were increased. Every spare cent that people had saved was spent on war bonds that funded the massive machine of military and industry. Petrol was rationed, motor racing was banned, not a drop of oil could be spared. Not a single tire turned that could be used in the fight against the Axis of Japan, Germany, and their allies. Before the war, 17% of Americans were unemployed. By the time we fought the Japs at the Coral Sea, unemployment was 5%. In the end, 40% of total production was dedicated to the war. The sleeping dragon had been awakened. The war wasn't just won by the men and the machinery. Behind the scenes, we had an army of code breakers working on breaking the Japs' JN-25 code. Working out of a basement at Pearl Harbor, the code breakers had intercepted messages detailing plans for another massive assault. Unfortunately, all of the Jap transmissions used code names for U.S. bases, so the target of the assault wasn't clear. The code breakers designed a ploy to establish that Midway was the target, as they suspected. They sent a false radio message reporting that the water distillation plant on Midway had broken down. Within 2 days, this message was relayed to Jap ships using the same code name as the assault location, confirming that the location of the next assault was indeed Midway. Knowing where and when the next attack was coming, we weren't going to be caught short again.